Hi, I'm Kathy Talbot, and I'm welcoming you to the 2013 Peekskill Open Studios. All around town, artists are opening their studios for people to come and take a look at the work they're doing, the work they've done, and in many cases, the work they're doing at the time. In fact, what we have here right on Main Street, we're on Main Street, we have an artist in the background, if you can see him in the background. He's painting. There's artist painting over there. I'm not really sure what it is, but it certainly looks interesting. And we're going to be going from touching base with a few studios in town. You can bring your children, you can bring your families, and just walk around Peekskill, enjoy yourself, and stop in one of our restaurants for a little refreshment. Hi, we're here with Adele Camp, who is from Croton, who's here painting beautiful pictures on a lovely piece of sail bark, it looks like.
Yes, it's a sailboat. It's the sea, you know, the Hudson River, the sea. And I have a dream of making it beautiful, but I can't compete with God. I got to tell you the truth.
Can any of us? I don't think so.
Anyway, but it's fun. It's fun. It's fun to see the people who come by and say hello and all kinds of good stuff like you.
How long have you been an artist?
I was a secret. Oh, somebody's bringing me water. I love you. Thank you. I've been an artist, I would say, for about 40 years. Wonderful. And for a long time, I was a closet artist. I was ashamed to show my work. Yeah. And I don't know, something said, it's time to shine.
And you used to have a studio here in Peekskill at one point.
Right. Yes,
right?
Yes, okay. Yes. Now I have a lot of paintings in a church, in the Presbyterian church. And I have a couple of paintings in a church right near the library also. There was a wonderful gal who lived here. She moved to Russia. And Olina, maybe some of you might know this. And her daughter had passed away, and I donated two paintings in her memory. It's at that church.
Nice.
Yes, that was very moving. It's a wonderful town.
It's a wonderful town. And on that note, thank you very, very much for stopping your work. And you're making the ocean. How can we stop you from that?
And the sky. Wait till I get to the sky.
Oh, the sky. We're here at the site of the former Nelly's restaurant with Stefan Eines, who is one of the organizers of this really interesting show.
The Fifth Dimension.
It's the Fifth Dimension, and I'm going to let Stefan tell us a little bit about the show and your work if it's here.
Sure, yeah. The show is, we have asked artists to respond to the physics facts established by Einstein about other dimensionality and quantum physics and related physics, you know, laws. And we ask artists to respond on their own terms to those facts. I mean, 90% of the universe we have no idea about. Do I have to say anymore? Okay, so it's about all that. Yeah.
And do you have work in the show?
I do have a number of pieces in the show. Yeah.
Would you like to show them? Would you like to show them to us?
Sure, there's one up there. Living forever according to laws of physics not yet understood.
And the fact that it's up there, is that part of the art expression itself?
Yes, I mean, I would like to hang shows differently than the standard way. And this is a good example.
Okay. What about all of these? Everything that's on that sort of clothesline, is that it different people?
I have two more pieces. I'd like to show at least another of my pieces.
Okay. What we'll do is we'll move back there. Let's finish here.
Yes, right.
And then...
This is a collaboration by a number of artists who come here.
All of these pieces collaborate.
Grimm, Shel Mayer, Brooke McGowan co-organized this show with me. She lives and has a studio around the corner. Emma and Diamond, those are collaborations.
So they worked together or they worked in tandem?
They worked, you know, whatever, together or after each other, any which way.
Sequentially.
Yes.
Yeah. It's very interesting.
Thank you. She did this, Brooke, my collaborator in this co-curator, she did this from one piece of paper, okay?
Really?
Now you tell me
how
that works, okay? Talking about other dimensionality, okay?
Holy smokes.
Right. So this is a found phenomenon. I located at Main Street between 950 and 970 Main Street, between North Division and the City Hall. And I call it the alien abusive personified force, and I also call it devil or Satan. And it's relates to the possible reality of the existence of the alien abusive personified force.
Hi, we're here with Linda Fassier. She's from Fishkill. And Linda, why did you come today?
We came to see the open studios that's going on today and tomorrow in Peekskill. We're really excited to look through everything that they have. My sister's an artist, she lives in Brooklyn, and I was a painter in college, so really interesting.
Have you been here before?
Actually, I grew up in Shrub Oak.
Did you really?
Yes, I did, went to Panis.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Well, I won't hold you up any further. I'm sure you're gonna, from the little bit that we've seen in our walk around so far, it's looking to be very, very interesting.
I'm sure there's probably a lot of really great work and a lot of diversity, so.
Terrific. Welcome back to Peekskill.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Bob Barthelmess, and it looks like you've pulled the sitting at the table duty.
I've pulled the 1:30 to 3:30 shift.
Okay, so how's business?
Oh, so far it's very good. I mean, I've only been here since 1:30, and we've had quite a few people. And, you know, some from out of town looking for specific things, and some just generally want to walk around. But there are a lot of places open today, a lot of studios, a lot of galleries. And, it's going very well. God knows it's a great day, isn't it?
I'll tell you, this is very well organized. Not that other years weren't, but I'm very impressed with the signage.
The graphics are very strong, and, it helps a lot. And I love the banners on the street. Have you seen those?
Don't you love those? Yeah. Aren't they great?
We didn't have those in the past, and it adds a lot to it.
Yeah, I looked all the way up North Division Street, and they're all the way up.
It's
a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's an absolutely fabulous day. And the balloons we have for the first time.
I'm Katrina Ellis. I'm the Director of Communications at the Hudson Valley Center for Contemporary Art, or HVCCA. We're a contemporary art museum here in town that specializes in putting on exhibitions of cutting-edge contemporary art and installations, plus doing a lot of education, including adults and education, but also for kids, to get them really knowing about art from an early age and appreciating it. We have a lot of upcoming events, but we're really happy to be working with the Peekskill Arts Alliance on the open studios. We have free admission all weekend for this event. Sorry. My lovely colleague Alana, she's one of our interns. We do this is part of our education program, is working with people that are in college she's in arts administration at Purchase College. So she's helping us out today.
I'm interning with the Hudson Valley Center for Contemporary Art, and I'm learning a lot about our educational programs and the type of and what really goes into running an arts organization. It seems it's a lot of work and a lot of fun, and I look forward to continuing my internship this summer.
Hi, we're here with Marcelino and Sandra Hagan, and here is some beautiful artwork.
Thank you. I'm Marcelino, and this is my wife, Sandra, and I'm a photographer. and we live in Pisco. We've lived in Pisco for 3 years now, and we love the area. We love the area. We moved from downtown New York, and we're here, and we love it. And this is my work here, and we're looking forward to just being part of Open Studio Week. So, you know.
Wonderful. Thank you. You want to say a few words?
So we have some photography, realistic and abstract photography here, as well as some pastel paintings and clay work, and we hope that everybody can come downtown. It's a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of fun, and we're great to have everybody come down.
Where is your studio in case this airs after today, which it may?
We don't have a studio, so we basically do it from our house, and then we come out, and we've been given permission by the Peaceful Arts Association, Art Alliance, to be able to bring it out here and just show it out here.
Perfect, perfect.
Again, and I'm really happy. I made my first sale already, so that was like that's great. You know, I had to put that in there. You know, so that's also awesome that we have the support of the community, and the community supports their artists. So that's the beauty of it. So,
Boy, I couldn't say it any better. And I'm delighted that you've got a sale. Thank you so much. Hi, we're here with Lana Yu, an artist who is showing her works, which are quite a decent-sized art, here at the Chamber of Commerce building on right off Park Circle. And Lana, can you tell us a little bit about this piece of art?
Oh, well, Kathy, thanks so much for asking. This piece I exhibited for the first time 2 years ago, actually at the H Art Gallery next door. Now a print of it is here at the Chamber. This piece is part of my Crinkle Canvas series that's actually based on paper that's been crinkled and then painted over, where I'm seeking an order within this sort of random array of lines and shapes. So it's really about finding harmony in a chaotic landscape. And there are a few pieces like this here, as with this one as well falls in that series. Okay. And then there's some new pieces as well that were painted within the last year that are very expressive in nature, utilizing droplets of watercolor. So, yeah, I welcome people to come and see. It's here at the Chamber.
Yeah. Do you have a studio that you're working in Peekskill, or?
Yes. I'm on South Street, right by the post office, at the Peekskill Art Lofts. People can find me at lanayu.net if you want to, you know, reach out to me and have a private studio visit. I'm happy to share my art there as well. But this show is going to be up for 3 months at the Chamber through August 23rd and probably beyond. So come by any, you know, time, Monday through Friday, 9 to 4:30, I believe, are their hours. 9 to 4 during the week, yeah.
Oh, great, great. This is just, your work is very impressive, and this piece in particular is really gorgeous, and thank you for letting us interview you.
Of course, I appreciate the opportunity. It's really an honor. Thank you.
Here at the newly opened Peekskill Paramount Center, Paramount Hudson Valley now called, and we're at the gallery upstairs, which has a wonderful showing of two terrific artists, Joseph Scalante and Richard Bruce. I encourage and invite everyone to come by, see the, it's nice to be in the Paramount once again, I have to say, very nice, and to see this gallery open and active too. So come on by, upstairs at the Paramount. Thank you. Hi, we're here with Maureen Winzik, artist extraordinaire, over on Brown Street. She has her new studios on Brown Street. And she is the head of the Peekskill Artist Alliance and has done a phenomenal job this year. I want you to know that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, what are you working on now?
Personally?
Yep.
Well, I'm working on painting. You know, I love my landscape scenes. I'm moving more towards figures as well, because as an artist, I get bored if I'm doing too much of the same thing, so I mix it all up. You'll see that I have portraits and draped nudes.
And you said you just came back from taking a look around town.
Yes.
You must be very proud of this.
I'm thrilled, because something in the air. There's a huge buzz this year, and you know, I have like a buzz machine that I try to create, and everyone kind of bumped it up a notch. You know, the 12 Grapes got two phenomenal photographers and set up for the first time in there ever, and they're thrilled. There's pop-up galleries that are thinking, you know, the thought is, let's do this during Open Studios because it's a great event. And they're just bringing more and more quality, you know. Someone said, yeah, I hope you don't think that we're taking away from your thing. We're actually hitching our wagon to your star. So, and that's how I think of it, yes.
We were over at some of the things on Main Street where they're doing expressive art on canvases that are out in the open in the sculpture garden.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I drove by there today on my way looking for an air conditioner, and I saw these like sails. They almost looked like sails. Yes. And Wilfredo Morel and two other artists have different brand new things in there, and the city and everyone cooperated in manicuring the lawn and making it beautiful. Yes, it's gorgeous.
And it looks like the signage, I want to particularly note the street signs.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we owe all of that to the Peekskill Business Improvement District, the BID. Amy Hart, who does this voluntarily for the BID, is working on branding our city, and she's doing a great job. They really make a huge statement, and we're very proud of it. And it coordinates with all of our marketing materials, so we're very proud of that.
Well, it really is exciting to see when I look up North Division Street and you see all the red banners. Yeah. So Open Studios does have a brand now.
It does. And we'll be keeping that every year. Those banners will go up, and you know, it's a recognizable event, so we're thrilled with that.
Yeah. Well, Maureen, congratulations again. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Kathy, and enjoy the day.
Here with Marcy Friedman at the Brown Street Studios on Brown Street, and pleasure to be in your studio. You are so prolific.
Thank you very much. I've been a Peekskill artist for a long time. In fact, I would say that I am in the 16th year of Open Studios because I've been here from the beginning.
16. We were trying to figure that out earlier,
yeah,
which 16. One it was, 16. This one seems like it's bigger and better than ever.
I've been telling everyone that this is the most impressive open studio I've been a part of, and I've been a part of all of them, because in addition to all the visual arts studios, which are always a part of it, EMC has opened it up to all kinds of performance art and music and poetry and theater, and it's fantastic. Plus, there have been more venues. I mean, there are all kinds of pop-up galleries and people in tents on the street. It just really shows the vibrance of this artistic community, artistic in all meanings of the word.
Absolutely. Thank you for making that point, because we've been going around and it's been phenomenal. Yeah. So what do you have here?
I have two posters in my hands because I am a visual artist, and as my studio shows, I've worked in collage, appropriation art, painting, drawing, small sculpture. But for the last many years, I've primarily been a video and performance artist. And my video work is often done in collaboration with Gene Penchenko. And this is a video that we decided to have its world premiere during Open Studios. So the video is called Woman's World, and it's on view at the Peekskill Coffee Shop Saturday and Sunday from noon to 5. It's a very humorous, whimsical video with an interesting level of poignancy. And if you watch the video, I promise you, you will laugh and get a kick out of it.
We're going to go right across. That'll be the next stop.
Excellent. And this is what I'm holding, because this is a representative of my work as a performance artist. And performance art grew out of very strange events and happenings in the Dada period and in the Fluxus period. My performance art used to be on stage doing a monologue. My performance art now is one-on-one, face-to-face, interactive. And I do it that way because I really feel that we all spend too much time on Facebook and email and texting and blogging. And human communication, I think, should be face-to-face. So this is a performance I'm doing next week as part of the Hudson Valley Center for Contemporary Art Peekskill Project. So they have a venue at 417 Main Street, and they're going to have installations and sculptures. And on Sunday, June 9th, I will be doing a performance called Once Upon a Time is Now. And I will be talking to individual people, one at a time, about the past, the present, and the future.
Isn't that fantastic? Boy, that's interesting. That's very provocative.
I think so. And I find that people, they're shocked that I, as an artist, would move to this very different form of expression. But for me, it is a form of expression, and it engages people. Because I don't like art to be just for an elite, moneyed power crowd. I like art to be for everyone. So this has been my way of bringing art to the people.
Power to the people.
Art for the people.
Art for the people. I'll second that. Thank you. Thank you very, very much. I appreciate you taking your time and look forward to seeing your performance as well as your video that you did with Jean.
Good. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Hi, we're here with Grace Morris. Grace Morris Designs, and this is Grace in the Brown Street Studios on Brown Street, upper floor. Hi, Grace.
Hi, how are you?
Oh, we're doing great. How are you?
Thank you.
I didn't know that this was here. So tell us a little bit about your business.
Okay, my business is mainly, I work with fabrics. I make Roman shades, draper panels, pillows, anything for your home. I am here to help you with. And I moved in here 6 months ago, and I just love it here in Peekskill. I love the artistry that is around me, and it is just a wonderful place to be. And I'm just hoping that, you know, some of the local people will come in and support my business.
So you come to someone's home and take a look, and then you decide what you want to create, or they come in with an idea?
They can come in with an idea, help them also to, you know, to decide on what is best for their windows or for their home. I can do that as well. And they can come in. I welcome people coming in, you know, make an appointment and come in. It's better to work with that, an appointment. And I'll also be opening my studios on Fridays and Saturdays for, you know, people to just walk in.
Wonderful. And do you have like swatch books for the
fat? I do. Yes, I have swatches around, and I can refer people to online too, so they can shop online as well. I also have an online store. I deal with the fashions .etsy.com that you can shop from home, and it's a little less expensive to do your own shopping, measure your own windows, and we can work from that point as well.
You want to say that website again, sort of slowly?
Surely. It's idealwindowfashions.etsy.com.
Dot E-T-S-Y?
That's correct.
.com.
.com, yes.
Fabulous. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And my son is here with me today, Dane Andrew, and he's a budding artist as well. He's venturing on, you know, starting a little tie business here, bow tie, bringing back the bow ties, and he's wearing his own handmade bow tie today, too.
And what a sharp young man you are. Look at you.
Thank you. Hello, how are you doing? I started making bow ties in my junior year at Fordham University. I went to a bunch of thrift stores and got vintage ties, and just cropped them and started putting together a few little projects. So now it's become a little hobby of mine, and it's been marginally successful. It attracts a lot of attention, so I'm seeing where this craft goes. So
Well, it's been a lot of fun.
You're a young man. You know all about social media, right?
Yes.
And pictures and all that stuff, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. And so it's the biggest venue, social media. It's a great enterprise to advertise my work. And so a lot of positive feedback coming from social media. So.
I bet. I would bet. Yeah. They're very attractive.
Yes, absolutely.
Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you too. Thank you.
Good luck with your business. We're here with Wendy Garber at the Flatiron Gallery. Wendy has been around Peekskill. She's seen more than her share of open studios.
Oh, yes. This is so exciting. I think this is the 17th open studios, and my gallery is 17 years old, so we must have started at the same time. But anyway, it's a great day. A little bit hot, but people are enjoying. They're coming in and cooling off and enjoying the art. And many, many artists are participating at the Flatiron building that we're in. We have our gallery, of course, named after the building, Flatiron Gallery, but we also have 8 art studios that are open, so if people come in today or tomorrow, they can really see a lot, even just in this building. And then we're giving out maps so they don't get lost and they can see all the other great exhibits all over town. There's many exhibits. Yes. So come back tomorrow if you can, because we're having even a bigger party tomorrow on Sunday.
Is there any, tell me about one or two, you know, perhaps one or two of the artists that you have here.
Okay. Well, this exhibit mainly is of printmakers, so we're going to see, this is a Peekskill artist. She's in the Brown Street Studios across the street, Ilse Schreiber-Knoll. This is a beautiful woodcut. And these printmakers all are part of a group called the Carrier Pigeons that also are published in a Carrier Pigeon magazine. And these, here's samples here that we're selling.
Right here.
And these go all over the world. They're internationally known. In fact, they also exhibit together in many places, not just New York. So they're exhibiting, have an exhibit in Peru right now, as well as Peekskill. So they go from Peekskill to Peru, you know. I'm very lucky to get such high quality artists, but Ilse is a Peekskill artist. She's part of this group. Also, we have Alana Gorin, who did this beautiful etching of the giraffe, and she's across the street too in the Brown Street Studios, and she's part of this group. Now, the other artists are from Manhattan and New Jersey, so I'm just getting to know them. But I will say that I just met this woman who dropped off this piece. She just moved to Peekskill. She bought a home here on Orchard Street. Her name's Anna Golici. And when she told me she was moved to Peekskill, I said, oh, Anna, that's wonderful. Join our, you know, our art group. This is so great that you're going to participate in our show. And she said, I don't know any of the artists yet. I just got here, and I'm enjoying Peekskill. How do I get to meet everybody? So I said, oh, we'll join the Peekskill Arts Alliance. We're going to have lots of fun. I'll introduce you to all the artists. And Peekskill is really a terrific community. It's easy to meet people. So I'm so glad it's thriving. Yes.
Well, thank you very, very much. It's, as always, I always enjoy coming up to your studio, your gallery, rather.
Thank you.
And because you've got excellent taste.
Well, I love that we have so much variety. And this is our main show. But if people have time to browse, they can also see the other rooms. We have handcrafted jewelry, we have sculpture, pottery, glass. We have another big room upstairs with larger paintings. Some people are here all year round exhibiting, and some people are here just for a special show. But thank you so much for coming in. I appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
Hi, we're here at the Embark Studios on South Street, where we just saw a beautiful dance performance by Andrea Alum and some of the young children that she works with. This is so great to see this place in particular with their performing arts and poetry and other types of things. So if you haven't stopped by the Embark Studios, please come on down. It's just a wonderful place. Well, here we are with Larry D'Amico. Hi, Larry. How are you?
Hi. How are you?
Larry's studio is a joy to behold. It was the old Field Library in years gone by, so it has these, I don't know, 50-foot ceilings or something.
Well, they're 20. But
20, yeah. I exaggerate.
Yeah. Well, you know, and it's also got a lot of soul. I mean, it was a church, so
it was
a Presbyterian church.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So tell us, what are you working on now?
Well, actually, I'm working on the piece that's on the floor right here. This guy is from where the Croton River and the Hudson meet.
Oh, nice.
And it's something that I've been working on this spot for about the last 20 years.
Wonderful.
I go back to this spot over and over again to work from it.
Beautiful.
And
beautiful.
Basically, you know, I've worked there, but most of it's studio. It's really about the feel of it and the sense of atmosphere that's in that spot that really gets to me. You know, the sense of those two rivers coming together, and it's really a gorgeous spot. Very quiet.
Looks very peaceful.
Yeah, that it is.
Just gorgeous. Must have been around since the beginning of Open Studios?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We've been here. We bought the building in 90, actually the end of 91, and we moved in about the beginning of 93. It took a couple of years to renovate the place, but we've been here. And actually, we've been here through every Open Studio that we've had.
It seems this year it's getting, it's really taking off. From last year was the rebirth in one sense, and now it seems like there's more artists.
I think that there's more activity from the pop-up galleries and all that going on here. In fact, we've got less studios open this year than in other years, but we've got more galleries and we've got more spontaneous groupings of artists coming together. So it's really pulling in more artists from the area than we've had before, which is great.
I love seeing some art happening on the streets, like up at the sculpture gallery on Main Street.
Oh yeah, that's cool. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun to see.
Yeah, I didn't get out there because I've been trapped here. But I talked to Wilfredo, and he said they're going to be out there tomorrow morning, so I can see him before the Open Studio.
Wonderful. That looked like a lot of fun up there. And thank you very much for sharing a few minutes on camera.
Oh, no problem.
Hi, we're here with Toni Quest at the Screaming Woman Studio. She's currently on the second floor. Right here on Main Street, and I understand you're moving.
I am moving, yes. I'm moving to the Art Lofts on Central Avenue. It'll be a very similar space, but on the first floor. Easy access for all of my fans and customers. They'll be really happy because I have some very steep stairs in this place, although I love it here in the Prudential Rivertown Realty Building. It's nice, but just a little too steep.
Well, I see that you are into producing a lot of one-of-a-kind jewelry.
Yes, I am doing a lot of jewelry. It's sort of like an art form that found me because I thought of myself as fundamentally a painter until I got, like, real handy with a jeweling tool.
And so I'm finding that people will buy the jewelry, like, right off of me, the rings. They'll buy them right off of my hands, and I give people what they want, basically. But, yeah, jewelry found me, three-dimensional art, and wearable.
And wearable. I love that. I am a proud owner of one of her beautiful bracelets. You recall that one?
Yes, you are, indeed, yes. And I enjoy doing it. I like doing custom work as well. I've been doing quite a bit of that. And I'm finding that if people have an event to go to, they want a special color, a special piece of jewelry. I'm designing for Alexis Cole, who's singing tonight. She'll be wearing my work, as she sings her beautiful jazz songs at the Tea Room. Mm-hmm.
Very nice, very nice. Downstairs at the Tea Room, Kathleen's Tea Room.
Kathleen's Tea Room, I'm right next door, literally next door. Yeah, so I find that the jewelry found me. You know, I didn't really seek to get into this art form, but it did find me, and I do feel comfortable when I have a plier in my hand. I like that. I don't know what it is.
A tool. Nice to have a tool.
Yes, a tool. Yeah, I've been teaching it as well. And as a matter of fact, during this open studio event, I was able to get, oh my goodness, I got about three new students for jewelry, which is nice. And so they'll actually take lessons here in my studio.
Fabulous. I'll see how it's like all growing and changing. It's wonderful.
It is. It's. I find that there are certain art forms that find me. And I think that might be true of a lot of artists. You really don't know what you're going to do until circumstances present. And then whatever it is sort of finds you. That's why I look at it. It finds me. And then I embrace.
And I'm glad that we found you today. Found you in and had a chance to chat. Tony, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
My pleasure. Thanks for stopping by. Come back soon.
Well, there you've seen it, but you've only seen some of it. There's many more studios that we haven't been to today. There's the Hat Factory up on North Division Street, which is a little bit outside of town, with some phenomenal places up there. And there's other places in Peekskill, all up in the upper floors of a lot of these buildings. There's work, live workspaces where the artists produce their work. So please come down and enjoy Peekskill for all it has to offer.